Election rigging, leaked ballot papers found in rooms that are not secured, questionable people working at the IEC, then South Africans' anxiety goes up. The people are asking, can we trust the IEC? Is it possible for the ANC to influence the results of the IEC? Is the IEC as an organization that South Africans can trust? How is the counting process? That's something I want to show you guys today. Can you trust the personnel of the people working in the IEC? Had they been properly vetted? South Africans are asking questions because they have a reason to suspect that this election might not just be as free and transparent as people think. There's always someone trying to do some type of criminal event. The people who will be appointed by each political parties at the different voting stations have got a lot of work to do. This is not a joke. This is a matter of life and death. You're not only counting votes, you are counting and determining the direction of a country. Yo, let's talk about that and much more.
Welcome to King Said So, Africa's one land, one language, one currency, one army on King Said So. Africans can unite, your Pan-Africanist podcast. Enjoy.
Black Heart, the hustle continua, 100% good quality t-shirts, made to inspire your goals and dreams. T-shirts are now available at an affordable price. Place your order now, 068-473-6908, Instagram at Black7576, Facebook page Black Heart.
Guys, me Naja, I'm Tunkamba Manga. I get some cocoa with door. Gai Figela, Gifunu Bonella is the IFP. Magabetu and Joconda wrong in Gibugila, Gatelum Pete, Gilanjum and Manjum, so Pigalama put into our call. And Spatolila is the IFP. Explanation, no man can get happy from the IEC because if go voting, but the satellite finally engabe kuba ukuthi indawo engasetshenziswa during that time. Kunama meeting engabe u2 abe khona la from different political parties engengize ngwabemeze ukuthi mabi. Ingakho bekwazile ukubona le nto eyenzakala.
Now I'm a ballot paper. My ballot paper now from IEC. My ballot paper. I deliver when I must say no ink. 2 days before election, they already delivered my ballot paper. Called the Massachusetts, I was looking at IEC. It's the last to deliver in it, real. Not a ballot paper. The ballot paper is delivered.
Asian Kili and Siwema, eh? Colonel Mopera Primary, Elangabini, eh? In there, nature stale. In get and I sank on. I am Gaboni Gaman Colonel, I'm a peaceville colonel. I'm a day, my day, one day. Eh, my ever says, be paid and Ozumagalali.
Peace in Pan-Africanism to all my African brothers and sisters from all around the world. Welcome back to King Tetso. I'm your host, King 053, Mr. Easy Imali, Enengeneng. And we're back at it again with another one. And this time around, we go to Hammersdale. Hammersdale, Bafetu, wait a minute. Is Hammersdale in KwaZulu-Natal? And is there a place in KwaZulu-Natal called Mpumalanga? Ngazodlalanga atitini. Mpumalanga... KwaZulu-Natal people, Kazanlap, Unendao, KwaZulu-Natal, anything in Mpumalanga. When I'm Mpumalanga singing time, what am I doing wrong here? I'm trying to search where this Hammersdale is. But anyway, it looks like there is a place by the name of Mpumalanga. I mean, Mpumalanga is a province. You know, it's a province here to Nichoyla Gabinina, Nienza, Indao, and Jepela Lap, with Mpumalanga A, Mpumalanga B, Inlok. You know, it's a province. Mpumalanga is a province. The holy province, the province with the pyramids. How? Anyway, before I lose what we came here to talk about, on a very serious note, Bafethu, ningacabanga ukuthi there isn't people that are corruptible in the IEC. Don't make that mistake. Masithi elections are bought. We mean that serious cash money. Hey, I'm talking about serious cash money is being shown to a party volunteer. A serious cash money is being shown to an IEC volunteer official. Serious cash money. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? Serious cash money. When you buy elections, you bring about cash. You take these volunteers, the EFF volunteer, you bring him. You go to the corner, you show him the money. You're like, no, take these votes, take this money. This is a good 50,000 for you. This is a good 5,000. For other people, you can buy them with 5,000, 10,000. Depending on their level of poverty, their level of political maturity, depending on everything. The person says, to hell with Cope, man. To hell with Rise Mzansi. Let me take this money. I'm not working. This money is going to sort out my problems for this month. Serious cash money. IEC are not robots. IEC are people. Don't tell me about the police. Labo, don't tell me about the police. Normal police that you see running around driving a police van with a gun with two clips on him. That police is earning between 14,000 and 21,000, depending on how many years he's been in the force. Those ones are bought easily. Don't tell me about police. Those ones, buy again. Remember, the police has now observed people that are not there because they wanted to be a police. They are there because they wanted a job. Their dream was never to chase against suspects. You understand what I'm saying? So, it's easy to buy people. It's, ask me, I'll tell you. It's easy to buy people. The most honest people you will think, a pastor being bought with money. Pastor changes. Politicians being bought with money. Politicians changes. So the IEC has got a big task here to find honest civilians, honest, hardworking people who will try to make this elections as transparent as possible. Now, when we look at the counting process of the IEC, on paper it looks like it's difficult to rig what is happening there. On paper, you understand what I'm saying? So obviously, the first step is to all ballot boxes are located to a voting station. Are accounted for, sealed ballot boxes are opened and emptied. So the ballot papers, the ballot are sealed and they're opened in front of people, the party agents and all. Everyone is there when they open the ballot papers. Everyone can see. Even on the videos that you see there where these leaked ballots are, you can see they are sealed. They still need to be opened. How I wish they opened them. How I wish they were opened. This is why you need serious party agents. You need someone who's vigilant, who knows the rules, who can check what is going on. Anyway, step two, unfold. Each ballot paper is unfolded and checked for Electoral Commission security stamp. Ballot without stamps are not counted. So there's obviously there will be people who will be trying to bring ballots without the stamp, and they will be putting votes there and all of that. Because, you know, not everyone is registered to vote, so they can put numbers there. The system can always be beaten, guys. And then they are sorted. All ballot papers are grouped according to the colors. You know, most regional, whatever, whatever. Regional, provincial, and national. Count and bundles. The ballots are counted and bundled into packs of 100. The results are counted for each party or candidate. Ne? Each party or candidate. So that's what is happening there. That's what is happening there. After that, obviously, now we have to now check. We have to reconcile on point number five. The results for various parties and candidates are reconciled against the number of ballots received and the total number of ballots cast at a voting station. And number six, it says there, sign results slips. Okay, this is the most important important part. It says results slips are signed by the accounting officer, independent ward candidate agents, and party agents. A copy of the results slip is posted on the door of each voting station, and then the other copy is transported to the local Electoral Commission office, where it is scanned and captured in the result system. Okay, the results are also verified by an independent external audit. So there is an audit firm also that also, you know, make sure that all of these results are correct. An audit firm is some people that you can also buy. We saw what happened with KPMG. Like, you don't trust auditors. Hey guys, auditors are there to cheat the system. Auditors are there to cook the numbers. That's what auditors are there for. I'm not saying specifically for this one. I'm just speaking just in general in life, with my experience with SARS business and everything. I'm telling you right now, auditors, don't think auditors are angels and whatever. Don't do that. I've told a story about how Auditor General in the Western Cape does not even check the departments. And you ask yourself as a department, if we are struggling with this, correspondent of departments, so the Northern Cape Department, let's say Department of Health, will call the Department of Health in the Western Cape and say, how are you guys doing this? And what they find out is that those guys are not even doing the right thing. Then the question comes, then how is it that the Auditor General can fault us here, but with you guys, they don't fault you with the same issue? It's a topic for another day. The Results Center, this is also another important thing. The Results Center are there for political parties, representatives, and independents to monitor the voting, counting, and result process. Parties have the opportunity to raise objections and any alleged irregularities. Other stakeholders present include the media and observers. Yeah, those invited observers, I think 180 people that are coming there to observe also. The final results and seats allocated for metro, local and local council, and are announced by the commissioner within 7 days, guys, of the elections. District council and are formed later once the local council has been constituted and have elected representatives to the district council. So after the counting of the results, after the voting, everything, in 7 days we can expect that a winner will be announced. Usually it's sooner than that. We will get probably, it's Wednesday, probably before, by Monday we will know who has won the results. As you know, only a few stations will be left and all of that. But it usually does not have a big impact in terms of significance of the numbers for Tuesday and Wednesday before the results are announced. So I just wanted to share that with you guys. Again, I repeat, everything can be corrupt. Everything has a price. Someone can just come here, the ANC people can just come here by me, drop a 5 million and say, King, from now on for 3 weeks or for 3 months or for 3 years, you're going to speak about the ANC only. And you guys all of a sudden suddenly see a change and you're asking yourself, how this King, wasn't he the Pan-African guy, whatever? Why is he reporting about the ANC all the time? Everyone has got a price. You know, a person like myself who earns less than 200,000 a year, you know, what is 5 million in cash? You understand what I'm saying? Not saying that we are all corrupt. I'm just making an example. There's other things. Some of us, we are principled and will rather go hungry because gradually our lives are improving anyway. But I'm just saying there's other people that look at it in that eye to say, yeah, fine, man. These are the elections of this country. There's nothing to do with me. I'm taking this 1 million and I'm putting this number in. I'm putting you. Don't be shocked after these people coming out saying this, saying that, people getting caught, police getting caught with ballot papers getting caught in a dustbin somewhere in a dumping zone, ballot papers in the streets, marked ballot papers, people getting, like, don't be shocked. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. Everyone can be bought. And you guys will just tell me on the comment section if you agree or not. But I just know for a fact, without any shadow of doubt in my mind, that people can be bought. And these are the most vulnerable people. These are cheap labor for me. These are cheap labor. Anyone working in the police force, any VD, any agent, any auditor firm, anyone, police, anyone can be bought easily for me. When you have something like, you remember they said, Cyril Ramaphosa was given 1 billion to win the election in the ANC. Imagine how much more can the white monopoly capitalists give for a national election. Because I told you guys, for white monopoly capitalists, for them, the ANC staying in power is not a problem. It's not a problem. The ANC is not a threat to white monopoly capitalists. They have shown for the past 30 years that they are not a threat. They are not taking anyone's land. They are not nationalizing anyone's mine. They are not nationalizing anyone's banks or anything. They are okay with that. They're just going to continue with the smooth sail, and it becomes business as usual. But anyway, let me not waste your time, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. Stay tuned to this channel. We'll be going on fire until we meet next time. Don't forget to pray. After you pray, stand up, African child. Do your best so that God can do the rest. Peace in pan-Africanism. I salute.